Hello guys and girls, so you might be aware that the gate response sheets are out for the geology and geophysics paper, and also probably curious about the answers. So here we are at the Geology Simplified with the explanations and answers. Please note that this is the part one of the series. In this video we'll be dealing with the general aptitude section. And also at the outset, I'd like to put out a disclaimer that there may be certain variations in the answers with the official answer key, even though we have tried our best to keep it as accurate as possible. So use these answers as a reference to gauge your performance, but don't rule out any variations. So starting with the first question, the fishermen, the flood victims owed their lives were rewarded by the government. Now in this case we can eliminate certain options, that is we can eliminate that because it would be a better choice if the subject would have been non-living thing. Then we can eliminate which would have been used if the subject was a singular subject, that is fisherman. Then there may be certain doubt between whom and to whom. But the better choice grammatically is to whom, because whom would have been the better choice if the sentence would have been something like the fishermen whom the flood victims owed their lives to were rewarded by the government. But the correct option here is to whom, the fishermen to whom the flood victims owed their lives were rewarded by the government. Until Iran came along, India had never been defeated in Kabaddi, because you'll have to use the past tense of the verb here because the event is already passed. So the correct option is defeated. Then you have to arrange these five numbers according to the directions given. There are three directions, and that is no two even or odd numbers can be together. Then coming to the second direction, that is the second number from the left is exactly half of the leftmost number. So using these five numbers you can create two such combinations, that is 10-5 and then 3 blanks, and or 4-2-3 blanks. And so 4-2 cannot be the case because both even numbers are side by side. So then you are left with 10-5 and then 3 spaces. Now the third direction is the middle number is exactly twice the rightmost number. So the middle number can be 4 and then the rightmost number will be 2. So the final sequence will be 10-5-4-7-2. Then the right number, second number from the right will be 7. Then volume of the circular cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. So if both radius and height are increased by 10%, so they become 1.1 r and 1.1 h. Then the final volume will be 1.1 cube pi r square h by 3. So this becomes 1.331, the initial volume. So the percentage increase will be final minus initial volume upon initial volume into 100. So that would come out to be 33.1%. Now the next question is about a statement, and then based on this we have to logically derive a inference, the necessary inference that is that will have to take place. So based on the statement, some students were not involved in the strike. Based on this we can draw a Venn diagram. In this Venn diagram you can see one circle towards the right is the area of the strike, and then towards the left is the students. The intersection has been marked as question mark because this area may be zero, or this area may be larger than what is shown here. Maybe half the students were participating in the strike, maybe none of the students participating in the strike, but the shaded portion is showing that some students were definitely involved in the strike. You cannot say about the students who were involved in the strike, but you can definitely say about the students who were not involved in the strike. So coming to the inferences, some who were not involved in the strike were students. Now this will always not be true. Then no student was involved in the strike. Again, this is referring to the area of intersection. That is, this area will in this case, this area will be zero. That is, no student was involved in the strike. So it is saying that absolutely no students were involved. So you cannot say that for sure. Maybe some students were involved. Then at least one student was involved in the strike. Again, this is again an absolute statement. You cannot say for sure how many students were involved. Then some who were not involved in the strike were students. So this is definitely true based on the given statement. Because some of the people who were involved in the strike, they were students. So option 4 is correct. C4 is the answer. Then this is a passage about Hindustani music. From this we have to basically derive nomenclatures, the contemporary and medieval nomenclatures. So Dhrupad here is Bani, then Gayaki is for vocal, Baz is for instrumental styles, and Gharana is for lineage. So the incorrect pairing, only one incorrect pairing is given in the option, that is Baz is here, it's institution, it must have been instrumental styles. So C, Baz institution is the correct answer here, that is it is the non-correct pairing. Then in the next passage, they have given an analogy based on prestige of a kingdom and the number of taxes, and then prestige of a headhunter in his own community. Now the prestige of a headhunter is not dependent on the prestige of the kingdom, is not dependent on the number of taxes he could levy. So A and C will not be the answers. Now if you take headhunter in the literal sense, that is a hunter who hunts heads, then you will definitely get the answer as the number of heads he could gather. In this case, from the passage, the headhunter are actually taken as the literal meaning of the headhunter. The headhunter is not someone like the hunter who is the prime hunter of a group or something. So answer is D, the number of heads he could gather, it decides the prestige of the headhunter. You can go through the explanation. Then in a country of 1400 million population, there are certain data given about the owners of mobile phones. Then 294 have access to internet. Among these, half buy goods from e-commerce portals. So half of 294, that is 147, they buy goods from e-commerce portals. And then we have to find the percentage of these buyers in the total in the country. That is 147 million divided by 1400 million into 100. That comes out to be 10.5%. So 10.5 is the answer. Then moving along, two trains, they're starting from the same spot in the opposite directions, north and south, and they're starting at the same time, 7 a.m. and we have to find after what time they will be 540 kilometers apart. So using simple algebra and the concept of physics, that since they are moving in the opposite directions, their relative velocities will be added. So the relative velocity will be 80 plus 100. Now suppose after x hours the distance between them is 540 kilometers, so the distance can be represented as 180x and it is given as 540. So after 3 hours the trains will be 540 kilometers apart. So after 3 hours means 7 plus 3, 10 is the answer. At 10 a.m. they will be 540 kilometers apart. Now, in the last question, there is a passage which talks about the repo rate, how RBI has reduced it, and then banking institutions made a demand to reduce the interest rates on the small savings schemes. So finally, heeding to the banking institution demands, the government reduced the interest rates to bring them on par with the fixed deposit rates. So based on this, we have to find which of the statements inferences are correct, is correct. The first one is, whenever the RBI reduces the repo rate, the interest rates on small saving schemes are also reduced. So this is an absolute statement and this is incorrect, because had it been correct, there would have been no reason for the banks to demand the reduction of interest rates on small saving schemes. Similarly, interest rates on small saving schemes are always maintained on par with the fixed interest rates. Now again, this is also incorrect, because for the similar reason as I mentioned above, that the banking institutions may not have needed to make any demand of that sort. Then the government sometimes takes into consideration the demand of banking institutions before reducing the interest rates. Now this is correct because this is what has happened in this case. It sometimes takes into consideration, not all the times, may or may not take into consideration the demand of banking institutions. Again, then D, the reduction in interest rates on small saving schemes follow only after the reduction in repo rate. This is again an absolute statement, and this is wrong because it doesn't happen only after it. It can happen even before it. It is independent. It is a decision of the government, and repo rate is part of monetary policy. So this is, if you have basic understanding of economy concepts, so you can find it that way, or even logically we can derive this. We can derive, and the correct answer so then comes out to C. So please do share this video with your friends who might be interested, and also subscribe to Geology Simplified if you want to watch more such videos. Of course, we'll be coming up with the rest of the solutions very soon. Thanks for watching.